Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. We have seen that many real-world problems can be modeled and solved using quadratic equations. And that single-variable quadratic equations can always be put into the standard form ax squared plus bx plus c equals zero, where a, b, and c are constants. A quadratic equation like this is formed by setting a quadratic function equal to zero. In the same way that a linear equation can be formed by setting a linear function equal to zero. However, quadratic equations are typically not as easy to solve as linear equations. For example, without techniques beyond what we have learned so far, the quadratic equation 6x squared plus 11x plus 4 equals 0 could be quite difficult to solve. If we graph the quadratic function 6x squared plus 11x plus 4, we see that there are two values of x which cause the function's value to be 0. But to find these x values, we must solve the quadratic equation. In the previous lecture, we introduced an interesting trick for solving quadratic equations. We showed that it is often possible to factor a quadratic function into the product of two linear functions. And the zeros of those linear functions will be identical to the zeros of the quadratic function, and therefore will be the solutions to the quadratic equation. So given a specific quadratic function, how do we go about finding its linear factors? Fortunately, there are several cases of quadratic expressions called special products whose factors can be easily identified. These cases include quadratic expressions that are the difference of squares and quadratic expressions that are perfect squares. In this lecture, we will see how to factor quadratics that are the difference of squares. Quadratic expressions that are the difference of squares can be written as two squared terms, which we will refer to here as terms A and B, where B squared is subtracted from A squared. One example of this would be the quadratic expression x squared minus 4, since 4 is 2 squared. First, we will show that any expression that is the difference of squares, a squared minus b squared, can be written as the product of two binomials, a plus b times a minus b. We can prove that this is true in general by multiplying the two binomials a plus b and a minus b, to see if we get the expression a squared minus b squared. Multiplying a times a gives us a squared. A times negative b gives us negative ab. B times a gives us positive ab. And positive b times negative b is negative b squared. Now, since negative ab plus positive ab is zero, these two terms cancel, leaving us with a squared minus b squared, which shows that quadratic expressions of the form a squared minus b squared can be written as the product of the binomials a plus b and a minus b. Since in the example x squared minus 2 squared, x corresponds to the first squared term a, and 2 corresponds to the second squared term b, the factors a plus b and a minus b are x plus 2 and x minus 2. Once we have factored a difference of squares quadratic expression into two binomials in this way, the zero product property tells us that the zeros of those two factors will also be the zeros of the quadratic function, which is their product. If we graph the quadratic function x squared minus 4 and graph each of its linear factors as functions of x, we see that the zeros of these two linear functions are identical to the zeros of the quadratic function. Finding the zeros of linear functions can be much easier than finding the zeros of a quadratic function. We simply set each linear function equal to zero and solve for x. So the zeros or roots of the quadratic function x squared minus 4 are the x values negative 2 and positive 2. And since these two x values cause the function x squared minus 4 to have a value of 0, they are the solution set of the quadratic equation x squared minus 4 equals 0. The zeros of quadratic functions that are the difference of squares will always be two points located equal distances to the left and right of the origin. And so the solution set will always consist of two constants of equal magnitude and opposite sign. If we wish to check our results, we can now substitute these values into the quadratic equation to see if they produce a true statement. We start by substituting the first solution, negative 2, for x. Negative 2 squared is 4, and 4 minus 4 is 0. So this confirms that negative 2 is a solution to this quadratic equation. Likewise, substituting positive 2 for x gives us positive 2 squared, which is 4, and once again, 4 minus 4 is 0. So positive 2 is also a solution, and our solution set checks out. Another example of a difference of squares is the quadratic expression 9x squared minus 25. This quadratic is the difference of the squares of the terms 3x and 5. So 3x corresponds to the first squared term a, and 5 corresponds to the second squared term b. Therefore, the factors a plus b and a minus b are 3x plus 5 and 3x minus 5. So to find the zeros of the quadratic function 3x squared minus 5 squared, or 9x squared minus 25, we can set the two linear functions that are its factors equal to 0 to find their zeros. Setting these linear functions equal to 0 and solving for x we see that the quadratic function 9x squared minus 25 has zeros of negative 5/3 and positive 5/3. Likewise, these two x values are the solution set of the quadratic equation 9x squared minus 25 equals 0. To check our results, we can now substitute these values back into the quadratic equation and see if they produce a true statement. Substituting negative 5/3 for x gives us negative 5/3 squared, which is 25/9. 9 times 25/9 is 25. And 25 minus 25 is 0. So negative 5/3 is a solution to this quadratic equation. Likewise, substituting positive 5/3 for x gives us positive 5/3 squared, which is once again 25/9. And so we get the same result as before. 0. So positive and negative 5/3 are both solutions, and our solution set checks out. So far, we have seen two examples of quadratic expressions that are the difference of squares. And in both examples, all the constants in the expressions were perfect squares. In other words, the constants were all squares of integers. However, the constants in difference of squares expressions don't have to be perfect squares, or even integers. For example, the quadratic expression x squared minus 3 is a difference of squares, even though 3 is not a perfect square. It is the difference of x squared and the square root of 3 squared. So x corresponds to the first squared term a, and the square root of 3 corresponds to the second squared term b. Therefore, the factors a plus b and a minus b are x plus the square root of 3 and x minus the square root of 3. So these are the factors of x squared minus the square root of 3 squared, or 3. Another example would be the quadratic expression 3x squared minus 7, which is the difference of the square of the square root of 3 times x and the square of the square root of 7. So the square root of 3 times x corresponds to the first squared term a, and the square root of 7 corresponds to the second squared term b. Therefore, the factors a plus b and a minus b are the square root of 3 times x plus the square root of 7 and the square root of 3 times x minus the square root of 7. So these are the factors of the square of the square root of 3 times x, or 3x squared, minus the square of the square root of 7, or 7. So the only requirement for a quadratic to be a difference of squares is that it must be able to be written as x squared multiplied by any positive constant minus any positive constant. When we recognize that a quadratic expression matches the form of a difference of squares, a squared minus b squared, then we know that the expression can be factored as the product of two binomials, a plus b and a minus b, which then makes it a simple task to find the zeros of the quadratic function and the solutions to the corresponding quadratic equation. In the next lecture, we will see how to factor quadratics that are perfect squares.